Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny, and today I'm going through 10 truths about lip filler you may or may not know. Now, lip fillers are drivers to our practices. It's the in thing now, and having larger lips than people have, or a trend towards a larger top or bottom, it's in style, people have an option, and so they're taking advantage of that. So 10 truths, we'll start with number one. You will swell. So if you get a needle put in the lip area, there will be swelling involved, and often it's worse on the second day. You're either gonna like the swelling and enjoy it and live it up, or you're gonna be scared a little bit and you're gonna retract and be scared people at work or your family or friends may see. It's one of the two, but you will swell. Number two, real product, legitimate hyaluronic acid, which is the number one product we put in lips, does cost money. So if you see something that's too good to be true, it likely is. Everyone asks, what's the range around the country? It's anywhere from $500 to, if you go to New York, it could be $1,800, and it depends on many factors, but it does cost money to get legitimate lip filler. It's not cheap product. Number three, you will look different. It's amazing how many people come in, and some people absolutely want to look different and they want to create different looks. But a lot of people come in for lip filler and they say, oh my, a week later, 2 weeks later, I look different. I'm not sure about it. And so if you don't want to look different, the easiest thing is don't get lip filler, but you will look different. Number four, small lips tend to stay smaller. Now, a caveat here with our newer products, there is a continuum, and lips can start small. A lot of times we can get them bigger over time, but the first time you get lip filler, if you're starting with small lips, with one vial, which is likely what we put into small lips, even if it's a strong, robust product, you're not gonna have large lips like maybe the picture you come in with the first visit. It can be done over time with many lips. Sometimes it's just not possible. Number five, you will want more. If you ask people who've had lip filler and say, how many vials have you had done? They don't quite remember. They say, I had one here, a half here, a couple last year. You'll lose track. But one thing is for certain, people who get their lips done, whether it's at 1 month or 1 year, always want more product. When you see a trend and you like the trend, it's human nature, we want more. Number six, you will need an adjustment. At some point in the realm of getting lip filler done, if you get it done long enough, you will want a little removed or a little more added within a few weeks after your appointment. Adjusting these products is normal. It's not necessarily the fault of the injector. It could be. They could have been heavy on the trigger in one area. But also, of course, lip product will flow to different areas based on a little bit of scar tissue. Maybe there was one design done where the center was filled a couple of years ago, and that area tends to have a little more laxity and want to take more filler. Maybe now you want a wider mouth and you're filling laterally where there's more tension in the tissue and the product doesn't want to stay or creates a bump or lump. A lot of these are temporary, but we get calls back, whether it's hours after filler or a few weeks, and people want adjustments. Following up with your practitioner can help guide you. But one thing is for certain, if you do it long enough, there will be a time where you want some sort of adjustment. Number seven, you will need one vial of filler. So what I want you to do here is go to the kitchen, grab a teaspoon, put something in it, hopefully something cohesive, and then pour it out into your hand. That's 5 mLs. That's equal to 5 syringes of filler. Most syringes come as 1 mL. So putting 1 mL into the lip is about the average that's used, and it's what you'll likely need on your first treatment. And remember, we're talking the lip, but the lip also is maybe the downturn, so it's filling a little at the edge of the lip. And whenever we look at a lip, we're also looking at maybe chin projection and jawline, which adds up, of course. But for the lip itself, you will need one vial. Number eight, you won't look exactly like the picture you bring in. almost everyone brings in a picture, says, I want to look like this. Sometimes it's very congruent with what can happen. And many times, maybe over time it can happen, or it may just not be possible. But to look exactly like a picture is a little unrealistic for some people. And creating shape is limited by the anatomy of the lip, the tension on the tissue in the existing lip. But it's great to bring those pictures in because we like to see what's in someone's mind. Sometimes it's possible, sometimes it's not, most likely not on the first visit. Number 9, there will be some level of discomfort. Everyone asks, is it painful? Well, the lip is a mucous membrane. It's one of the most sensitive areas we inject, but luckily we have many options to use anesthetic, whether it's vibration. Topical anesthetic works way better than it used to. It used to be everyone got a nerve block. The topicals weren't great. Now we have great topicals, and nerve blocks still can be done for those that don't want to have a topical or they don't want any pain, but literally getting those injections can cause pain in and of themselves, and lidocaine stings or burns when you put it in. So there'll be some level of discomfort, but no one can tell you, because we have people walk in and they say, wow, I thought that was gonna be painful. I didn't feel a thing. And there's other people that feel like that was very painful, one of the most painful things they had done, but it gives you a guide for the next time that you get your filler. That leads me in to number 10. And number 10 is, you will get used to it. Two things. So I'm cheating here a little bit, 10A and 10B. 10A, you get used to the discomfort. So people have had lip filler before, they come in and they may not want any anesthetic and they had anesthetic before. It's a fairly quick procedure, but you get used to getting it done. The B part of that is you also get used to the look. And so people come in and say, I don't think my lips are any bigger. And you show them the original picture and they're wowed. We get used to how we look, and often we want more, thus the Instagram pictures that we see, and thus the traffic for lip filler in North America and around the world. So thanks for joining me. There's 10 things about lip filler that we thought we would review with you today. We got more lip filler videos on our channel. Watch them. Subscribe to this channel. We do a couple videos a week on various topics of beauty to help you keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.